Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can visually see what broke the fold inside of Power Query. Let's go figure this out. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Alex Powers joined us in a previous video where he showed us the number one rule is don't break the fold.
There's only one rule. Don't break the fold.
All right, well, let's see.
If you haven't seen it, go check it out. So I'm going to take the example that he had in that video and take it a step further and show you visually how you can tell if you broke the fold and where that breakdown is. All right, enough of all this talking. You know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So we've got a similar example to what Alex did. So I've got products, I've got colors, and I'm doing a merge here, and we can see that we broke the fold because of that red indicator. So that's great. We can visually see that we broke the fold on the merge, but what exactly is happening here? Let me introduce you to the diagram view. This is amazing. The diagram view actually shows us how queries are related and what's going on there, but there's actually a bigger thing here. If I go look at that merge, we can see this is the merge, this step we ended up breaking the fold. If I right click and say view query plan, we can actually see a query plan for the Power Query operations. Look at that. Did you know about this? This is amazing. This is inside of Power Query Online in the service. So if you use Power BI Dataflows, you can actually go through and check this out inside of Power Query Online. Okay, so here we can see value native query. This is coming from my database. We want to see value native query. That's where the folding is going to actually happen. But we've got this table with column color, and we had to do this table nested join where it's buffering. That's where we broke the fold. The fact that it had to go to that operation, that's breaking the fold in this case. So let's see what this looks like when it's actually folding correctly. Keep a mental picture here of all these steps. This is causing a problem. So let's do what Alex did. So let me go back to our steps here. Let's get rid of the merge. We're going to go back to colors. We're going to drill down. So that makes it a list. Go back to products and we'll filter in, select a query, colors, right? So we're using the list now to drive the in. If we look at the data source query, we're doing the in and the where statement, and we can see that the fold is now happening, right? So let's go back and look at that view query plan. And now it's super simple. We just have value native query and bam, it's just sending that query. No more of those other operations that are present. It's just doing what it needs to do. So you can clearly see one where we're breaking the fold and where that fold broke in terms of its process. And then when we corrected it, what that query plan should look at. So take advantage of the query plan operations inside of Power Query Online to see what's actually happening. This is gonna make a big difference in how you go after Power Query and how you can help make sure that we're not breaking the fold. And then from there, we can copy our query back into Power BI Desktop and we're good to go. Did you know about this query plan? Let me know in the comments below, and maybe there's other tips that you have when using this. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching, keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.